One thing this is not is just another state visit. And although Deng Xiaoping on his arrival got the usual White House welcome at a South Lawn ceremony, the administration is giving him the kind of treatment over the next week not normally laid on even for a head of state or head of government. The visiting vice premier technically is neither, just the most powerful man in China. And his reception here included officially a 21-gun salute and unofficially a crowd of Taiwanese demonstrators outside the gates. Mr. Deng, warmly applauded by the invited White House guests, is here, of course, for more than an exchange of courtesies. And as even as he arrived, an interview with him was published here, in which he described the Soviet Union as a hotbed of war and called for an alliance between China, the United States, and Japan to place curbs on what he called the Soviet polar bear. Mr. Carter was rather more tactful in his own remarks.
We expect that normalization will help to move us together toward a world of diversity and of peace.
Mr. Deng himself gave a short pessimistic speech, saying that the factors making for war were visibly growing, but he shared the American sense of this as an historic visit. The two men then left for the first of their sessions together, starting point of a 7-day tour and a calculated diplomatic exercise.
The Texans, who pride themselves on their hospitality, had vowed that Mr. Deng should remember this as the best time of his trip. He'll certainly see nothing quite like it. They also expected that he and the other deputy premier, Fang Yi, should wear the Texan hat. And as if that wasn't enough, the Chinese leader was then taken in a tour of the rodeo arena by stagecoach. Only after that did the main event begin, a show not just for the few Chinese in Mr. Deng's delegation, but for the millions watching at home on television. And what were they to make of it? Their commentary would tell them that cowboys were not the gun-toting bad men of Wild West legend, but agricultural laborers and heroes of the people.
Here's Charles Treadway.
It had been supposed that Deng Xiaoping would address the crowd when the rodeo was over, but he left without doing so.
Well, ladies and gentlemen,
one theory was that he just found the Texans buzzer, but, inscrutable.
Zachary's fixing to get in trouble.
What?